في مسند البزار عبد الرحمن بن عقيل او عقيل and by the way it's very important to understand that this situation happened the year of the delegation one year before the death of the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم عام الوفود the ninth عبد الرحمن بن عقيل said I went to the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with a delegation and we entered and we looked at the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ما فيه شيء there is nothing in it just walls and mat and ما في شيء he has nothing he has no sofas he has no TV LG TV LD, I don't know what's that, LD, TG, has no satellite, he has no air condition, nothing, nothing. تخيل صح, they felt bad. فقالوا يا رسول الله, O Messenger of Allah, ألا تدعو الله أن يعطيك شيئا من الدنيا? What don't you make dua? That Allah gives you something, something. فضحك رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet smiled, and he said, "يا صاحبي, my friend, Allah سبحانه وتعالى will give me something much better than that." Then he said, "لكل نبي دعوة مستجابة." Every prophet and messenger has a supplication which Allah will answer. لكل نبي دعوة مستجابة. Every prophet will have a supplication that you make a request. منهم من دعاها لدنيا. Some of them they invoked Allah for the dunya. But we shouldn't understand that because they were dunya lovers. لا. They used it. They used the dunya for the akhirah. Like Sulaiman. What did Sulaiman say? قال ربي هب لي ملكا سليمان said oh Allah give me ملك give me dominion that no one else can have after me imagine the wind he would travel in the wind سليمان but he used it for the obedience of Allah زكريا ربي هب لي من لدنك وليا زكريا he asked Allah to give him a son but not for the dunya because يَرِثُنِي وَيَرِثُ مِنْ أَهْلِ يَعْقُوبِ in order to carry on the message after me وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ دَعَى بِهَا عَلَى قَوْمِهِ and some prophets used it to invoke Allah to punish his people like نوح وَقَالَ نُوحٌ رَبِّ لَا تَذَرْ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ ذَيَّارًا but You have to understand this in context. After Allah revealed to him that no one else would believe. وَأُوحِيَ إِلَى نُوحٍ أَنَّهُ لَنْ يُؤْمِنَ مِنْ قَوْمِكَ إِلَّا مَنْ قَدْ آمَنَ خلاص. No one else will believe, يا نوح. Then Nuh said, well, then anybody who's a kafir, they're drowning. Look what the Prophet said. غَيْرَ أَنِّي اِخْتَزَلْتُ دَعْوَتِي شفاعة لأمتي يوم القيامة. I saved my da'wah to intercede for you, for you, for you, for you, for you, for you, for everybody on the day of judgment. And we know, you know, the situations the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم encountered. Many situations, brothers and sisters in Islam, many, many situations. His life was under threat. They stood by his house at night to kill him. They offered a bounty for those who would catch him. They expelled him out of Mecca. They did all of this, but he never used that da'wah. He spared it for you because he loves you. As a matter of fact, one day he said to his companions, I can't wait till I see you, you. My brothers, he called us his brothers, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alasna ikhwanuka ya Rasulallah? Aren't we your brothers, ya Rasulallah? No, you're my companions. My brothers are people who will come after you, who will believe me without seeing me. When will you see them, Ya Rasulullah? On the day of judgment? How would you recognize them, Ya Rasulullah? The traces of wudu. He loves you. He longs to meet you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, are you feeling the same way? But how are you expressing this love? How are you doing it? Huh? Just one night, get together, eat some sweets. لا ما هكذا ما هكذا يكون الحب. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم.